Here is 200 AD, in the shadow of a large mound with a wooden temple atop it, stands a riverfront market. Fishermen carry out their work along the shore, which is full of canoes being prepared for various tasks. Travelers from across North America walk amongst the city, congregating in a vast plaza. This, however, is a time not much is known about, and the scene I have just described is merely an idea of the true goings-on within the ancient lost city of Crystal River. However, one thing we do know was its name. The people who inhabited this site likely called it Wiwahi Iaka. Crystal River was first settled around 500 BC by a group of Deptford culture mound builders. The earliest ritualistic burials at the site, however, began around 250 BC. People traveled long distances to bury their loved ones at Crystal River, and the site held obvious religious significance. It is estimated that somewhere between 1,200 and 1,500 people are buried in the various mounds throughout the site. The people buried around the site had copper tools and adornments, likely coming from the Ohio River, indicating a complex trade network developed by the Hopewell culture. However, later burials did not have these types of artifacts. People of Crystal River threw away large quantities of trash throughout their existence, and this trash formed multiple long outer mounds known as middens around the site. The middens at this site are 1,300 feet long, 100 feet wide, and 7 feet deep, forming a crescent shape around the site. Within the middens, various materials have been found, from animal bones and turtle shells to broken pottery and discarded tools. Near the midden are two platform mounds that may have been used as stages for ceremony, while the tallest mound at the site was dedicated to the temple, where a figure representing a high priest would have presided over religious and possibly even political matters. Along with the mounds, the site is home to a stele, a limestone slab inscribed with a head and torso. This is odd due to the fact that steles such as it are not found usually outside of the Caribbean, Central, and South America. There were at least four such stele at Crystal River in ancient times, but only one remains today. The stele shows a person with a long plume of hair over the left shoulder. It also puts into question just how wide Crystal River's trade networks actually were. Crystal River site was abandoned around the year 1400, nearly a century before the voyage of the explorer Christopher Columbus. It is unknown why the site was abandoned, but possible theories include food shortage, conflict, or natural disaster such as a powerful hurricane. In the modern day, Crystal River Archaeological State Park is open to the public so all can enjoy the marvels built by this mysterious civilization, despite the entire site almost being bulldozed by real estate developers in the 1960s. The site has provided much insight into the lives and practices of the Native Americans who used to inhabit Florida, and it will go on to for years to come.